Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonsom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 6th of July. Villages in India's Ayodhya lose dozens of houses due to soil erosion at riverbank. Taliban say will present written peace plan to Afghan government by next month. And Tibetan spiritual leader the Dalai Lama turns 86 says committed to serving humanity. And now for all the details. Villages in India's northern Ayodhya district on the bank of Sarayu River have lost dozens of houses and mud huts to erosion that accelerates during monsoon season. Slow erosion of land along rivers has been happening for a variety of factors for a long time. However, climate change and related weather anomalies have accelerated the process.
Villages in India's northern Uttar Pradesh state's Ayodhya district on the bank of Sarayu River have lost dozens of houses and mud huts to erosion that accelerate during monsoon season. The worst impact of this erosion is being faced by village Rampur Puvari Mancha. The villagers have erected a temporary wall with the help of district administration made of sandbags. The state government allocated hundreds of thousands of dollars for channelization through dredging in the villages for 7 kilometers along the bank of Sarayu. However, villagers say that the work is not in progress right now and what was done under the scheme was not fast enough.
Sir, iske liye koi nidhan nahi hai. Yahan lagbhag 50 ghar makan pakke kat chuke. Ram Pratap ko makan aapke samne dikh raha hai. Ye bhi katan mein hai. Inka parivar sara upar palli mein reh rahe hain. अगर यहाँ पर इसका कार्य नहीं किया जाएगा संतोषजनक से ये काम नहीं किया जाएगा तो बहुत नुकसान होगा हम लोगों का हजारों बीघा जमीन कट गई फसलें नुकसान हो जाएंगी गांव कट जाएगा
स्लो इरोजन ऑफ लैंड अलोंग रिवर्स हैज बीन हैपनिंग फॉर अ वैरायटी ऑफ फैक्टर्स फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम हाउएवर क्लाइमेट चेंज एंड रिलेटेड वेदर एनोमलीज हैव एक्सेलरेटेड द प्रोसेस थ्रेटनिंग टू लीव मिलियंस होमलेस बाय द एंड ऑफ 2050 अकॉर्डिंग टू अ यूएन रिपोर्ट
In news from Pakistan, Pakistan reported 830 new COVID-19 cases besides government, raising serious concerns over the violation of the standard operating procedures by the people, the National Command and Operations Center said on Tuesday. The daily case count has been over 1,000 since July 1.
Pakistan on Tuesday reported 830 new cases of novel coronavirus, less than 1,000 cases in a day mark for the first time in 6 days, pushing the country's case load to 964,490. The number of active cases has seen an upward trend during the last 10 days, increasing the figure to 33,390, while the national death tally since the pandemic started reached 22,452. The NCOC, National Command and Operations Center, a department leading Pakistan's campaign against the pandemic, on Monday issued a statement expressing serious concerns over violations of SOPs, the standard operating procedures, and warned of reimposing restrictions. With relaxations eased in the Sindh, government last week ordered the reopening of all the shrines along with indoor games. Local residents in Karachi city were seen visiting shrines to offer prayers.
बहुत से लोग इस पल के लिए बेताबी से इंतजार कर रहे थे कि मज़ारात खुलें और हमें कोई दिली सुकून हासिल हो जो यहाँ पर आके मिलता है तो मुझे आज यहाँ पर आके बहुत अच्छा लगा और मैं चाहती हूँ कि जितने भी आने वाले लोग हैं प्लीज़ खुदारा कोरोना वायरस की वजह से अपने आप को सेफ करके आएँ मास्क वेयर करके आएँ
Meanwhile, Pakistan's Interior Minister Sheikh Rashid said on Tuesday that the Torkham border would be closed from Tuesday for all kinds of traffic due to COVID-19 till fresh guidelines were provided by the NCOC.
Moving on, Pakistan People's Party Chairman Bilawal Bhutto Zardari on Monday hit out at Prime Minister Imran Khan-led PTI government for rising inflation and unemployment as he expressed confidence his party will win the July 25 election in Pakistan-administered Kashmir. Meanwhile, locals and political activists in the illegally occupied region have accused the upcoming election as a fraud, accusing that all major parties, including PTI, are indulged in pre-poll rigging.
PPP, the Pakistan People's Party chairman Bilawal Bhutto Zardari, on Monday said that his party would beat both Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf and the Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz Party in the July 25 election in Pakistan-administered Kashmir. Addressing an election rally in Nakheel area of the illegally occupied region, Bilawal hit out at Pakistan PM Imran Khan and said, under the puppet regime, millions have been left jobless and homeless while facing a tsunami of inflation due to government's failed policies.
आजाद कश्मीर के अवाम 25 जुलाई को पूरी दुनिया को पैगाम देंगे पूरी दुनिया को पैगाम देंगे कि आजाद कश्मीर को के अवाम एक अवामी जमात के साथ है पीपल्स पार्टी के साथ है वो ना मुजफ्फराबाद में कठपुतली जाते हैं ना इस्लामाबाद में कठपुतली जाते हैं.
Meanwhile, a protest was held by locals and political activists on Monday in Kotli area of Pakistan-administered Kashmir against what they termed as fraud elections in the illegally occupied region, accusing Pakistan PM Imran Khan's PTI party of pre-poll rigging.
जो pre-poll धांधली के जितने भी कोई रिकॉर्ड हो सकते हैं, वो इस इलेक्शन में बाकायदा से तोड़े गए हैं मुख्तलिफ सियासी जमातों से. लोगों को डरा कर धमका कर ब्लैकमेल करके तो इलेक्टेबल्स जो हैं वो पूरे किए जा रहे हैं.
Activists blame that successive governments in the illegally occupied region have over the years only worked at Islamabad's behest and helped it fill its coffers through economic depredations and exploitation of natural resources.
In news from Afghanistan, the Taliban plan to present a written peace proposal to the Afghan government negotiators as soon as next month, Zabihullah Mujahid spokesperson for the insurgent group has said. This comes amid an upsurge in fighting and major territorial gains by Taliban, which have raised grave doubts about peace.
The Taliban plan to present a written peace proposal to the Afghan government side as soon as next month. Zabihullah Mujahid, a spokesman for the Islamist insurgents, said, even as they make major territorial gains in the breach left by departing foreign forces. Taliban leaders renewed the long-stalled talks with Afghan government officials in Doha last week, reports suggest. However, the upsurge in fighting throughout Afghanistan since US announced in April that it would withdraw its troops by September 11 has raised grave doubts about peace negotiations. Afghan government forces were preparing a counter-offensive in Afghanistan's northern provinces after they were attacked a day earlier by the Taliban. Hamid Mubarrez, a spokesman for the Takhar province governor, said on Monday. Soldiers were seen in their trucks firing shots and patrolling the western gate of Takhar's capital, Talikan. Armed civilians were also guarding the streets of the city. With roughly a quarter of the country's districts having fallen to the Taliban in recent weeks, according to one study, many are concerned that chaos looms.
Moving on to news from Nepal. People queued in large numbers in Nepal for second dose of China-made Verocell vaccine, which is being administered to elderly people against the novel coronavirus disease from Tuesday. People of 60 to 64 years who had received their first doses of Verocell after June 25 will be inoculated with their second dose. This comes as Nepal on Tuesday reported 1,718 new coronavirus cases in the last 24 hours, taking the nationwide infection tally to 648,085.
The second dose of China-made Verocell COVID-19 vaccine is being administered in Nepal from Tuesday, and residents were seen lined up to get vaccinated in capital Kathmandu. The vaccine is being inoculated from 12 different vaccine centers in the Kathmandu Valley. People of 60 to 64 years who had received their first doses of Verocell after June 25 will be inoculated with their second dose. All those who had received the first dose of Verocell during the previous drives but had failed to receive the second jab so far are also eligible for the shot. According to reports, the vaccination drive will last till July 8 in Kathmandu district and till July 7 in Bhaktapur district.
अब सबै संसारै यही अब खोप लाएपछि बाँचिन्छ भन्नेमा छ अब विश्वास पनि गर्नुपर्छ नि त्यही विश्वासले लाउन आएको हो.
Vaccination drive resumed in Nepal's Bhaktapur city in June 8 after a fresh batch of doses arrived from China. The inoculation drive was stopped after India halted its export of vaccine during the second wave of the pandemic. Meanwhile, Nepal on Tuesday reported 1,718 new coronavirus cases in the last 24 hours, taking the nationwide infection tally to 648,085. The countrywide death toll has now reached 9,263. The number of active cases stands at 25,828.
Tibetan spiritual leader the Dalai Lama on Tuesday marked his 86th birthday in India's northern hill town of Dharamshala, where he has lived in exile for more than six decades. In a video message on his birthday, the Dalai Lama reiterated his mission to serving humanity and urged supporters to be compassionate.
Exiled Tibetan spiritual leader the Dalai Lama celebrated his 86th birthday via video conferencing with his followers on Tuesday in India's northern hill town of Dharamshala. The spiritual leader, in a virtual address, thanked people from across the globe who greeted him on his birthday and said he would continue to serve humanity and combat climate change.
And myself, I can assure to you, rest of my life, I committed serving humanity and protection of climate the condition.
Celebrations were held in other parts of the country, including Shimla and Buddhist Pilgrimage Center, Bodh Gaya, where prayers and cake cutting ceremony were held respectively. After a rebellion against the Chinese rule in 1959, the spiritual leader had exiled himself in India and has since been living mostly in Dharamshala.
Today we are celebrating the His Holiness the 14th Dalai Lama 86th birthday. Since the due to the pandemic, we are observing in a very low key celebration.
Meanwhile, several Indian leaders, including Prime Minister Narendra Modi, greeted the Tibetan spiritual leader Dalai Lama on his birthday. This marks the first time such a direct communication has taken place between the two sides since Modi took charge in 2014. The Dalai Lama was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize in 1989, and supporters operate a government in exile and promote Tibet's autonomy by peaceful means.
Millions of tourists have been thronging India's hilly state of Himachal Pradesh as the heat wave has hit the plains and the second wave of COVID-19 seeing a significant decline in the country. However, the increase in the number of visitors has posed a challenge to the authorities to ensure adhering of COVID protocol. Millions of tourists are flocking to India's northern hilly region of Shimla to beat the heat as coronavirus cases are decreasing and curbs are being eased. With 1,365 active cases, Himachal Pradesh state has seen a rise in the number of tourists coming to the hills after relaxations were announced and tourists were allowed to enter the state in a bid to revive the tourism industry. On Monday, tourists were seen enjoying the view of hills as they came out to travel after a long period amid the pandemic.
Precaution ke saath humne ghumna hai aur ki jisse itna problem bhi na ho, sarkar ko bhi problem na ho. Aur Himachal mein to jaise aaya na waise hi hamara matlab ki bata nahi sakte kitni khushi ka thikana hai nahi hai. Humne itna enjoy kiya is toy train mein, main to first time hi baithi hui.
However, the increase in the number of tourists has posed a challenge to the authorities to ensure adhering of COVID protocol by the visitors amid fears of an impending third wave of coronavirus infections. situated at 2130 meters above sea level with temperatures rarely crossing 25 degrees during summers. Shimla has always been the preferred holiday destination for domestic as well as foreign tourists to escape from the scorching heat. Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.